Kevlar. There is a kit on Nexa that could become valuable. Kicker only got the flashbang.
Oh, he flashed himself. No. Oh, dear. He knew he had a guaranteed kill there. The HP was so low, he just wanted to guarantee it with the flashbang. He hits himself in the face. Oh. And that could
Hey, guys. Today's video is sponsored by VMarket. VMarket is an easy and secure way to buy and sell your Rust, Dota 2, and CSGO skins. Their website is intuitive and easy to understand, with lots of tools such as filters to help you find exactly what you're looking for. They have a wide variety of skins available, as well as multiple cash out and deposit methods. Their skins are also a lot cheaper compared to Steam Market and other platforms. When selling skins, they only take 3% commission. Since VMarket is a new marketplace, they will be happy about any feedback they can get from you. So use my code SCOOBY for your first deposit to receive extra 50 cent bonus. Click the first link in the description to visit VMarket.
Fallen is alone on the site, and surely he will be hurt if he's running, but he's still walking. Fallen's alive, and he has to bank on Fallen staying alive. The CT spending time trying to find where these players are, and here comes Taco from the back, up the stairs. There goes Fallen, running distraction now. Surely Fnatic can't do this one. Taco playing the long game, just waiting for the clock to run down. And here he is, but he doesn't get a frag! It's an absolute disaster for SK! Fnatic steal another round!
Nines that surround it. They've got decent nades though. They've got decent utility, but with these Tech Nines, we can't see this slow spread out default that we've seen out of them recently. They've got to do something a little bit faster pace, and it is. It's going to be heavy towards the inner site. Davey gets the first kill. He sees more, but he stays to fight. He does fall, and that's a little bit rough. Huge advantage still for Splice, but CLG, they're pushing forward. They can find something here.
It's going to be Cutler that rounds out. He finds two kills back to back, but he gets caught trying to trade out a gun. Fugly finding another one. Jason R trades it back. And now it's Summit in the 1v1 to try and close this out against Fugly. Fugly playing it aggressively. No, but Summit's going to clutch it. And Splice will close out map number one, 16-11. Oh, wait. What?
Okay, then.
No. What happened? Oh no! Summit! No!
Oh, that is heartbreaking.
Look at this. Oh, look at this. Oh my god.
He fired five shots, he's in once for 99 damage. It's just ridiculous. He's having a jolly old time. There is no lack of confidence when you're doing that. You're flanking the entire team.
Making that mistake again. Optic must have been a little confused seeing those assists coming in from Scream after getting those frags.
There we go.
Here we go. We do get to see. Ah, he's just trying to throw it away, and he got it landed.
That's why you throw it backwards.
little bit of a risk that didn't need to be made there. If that is the mistake that gives Optic a way back into this game,
that's going to be the first.
That's going to be something you have flashbacks to in later life. That's something you need to sit on a couch. And
against the odds in a 4-on-2 situation, it felt like it was all done.
Unbelievable!
He has to watch on and let this round slip by the wayside. What happened there to Sunny? It must have been transitioning towards the bend.
Jumps off.
He jumps. Oh, he hit the roof.
He missed.
That's such a blunder. What's he done that for? You don't need to jump. You can just walk off and get towards the heart. I think he assumed it was done.
This is the Major after all. And it is E-League. Shout out to Arby's.
Absolutely excellent. Man, this crowd is definitely ready. I'm loving it, and so is Rain. He takes down Fur. That's such a good start. And Fallen is next in line. Rain finally going to be going down. No more of the Norwegian player. Fox trying to see if he can close it out on Kerrigan, and he will be able to. Still a 3-on-3. AZ's down, and that was Taco with the perfect timing. I think that actually saved Fox. Now the bomb is down, and Alu, he's still in kitchen waiting. That's such a powerful position. How are they going to make their way through? Oh no, they think it's the A bomb site.
No! Unreal.
This is a disaster for SK. They're spending all their time, all their grenades. They're not realizing it. Now finally it's going to dawn on them. We have been duped.
Get played, suckers! That's what Kerrigan's thinking. Unreal!
Put 3-0 lead here on their map pick. And that's exactly what we need to see.
Oh, this is it. Yeah, I was right. From those CT stairs down towards heaven, and that fall.
He's in a very difficult situation.
Both players on Envious very low. It's time for Bubble. He's got to shine. He drops Sixer down to 8 health. Sixer just desperately trying to survive, but he burns alive, walks into the flames.
And you know what? Because you're just so afraid of losing it. You know that it has, you know, that it can happen. And if it does happen, you're in a horrible position. So there's almost like more pressure in rounds like this. And it's like the reverse thing for the guys with pistols. They don't,
oh boy.
That's very nice.
That's what you get for spraying like you're at an Arabian wedding.
But either way, it's
oh my god!
WP, map point looking to be confirmed.
Oh no,
as Nitro nearly got knifed. Simple, of course, trying to push it through. And it's in style with a bit of sass.
If it goes overtime now, Matt, I don't know what will happen.
Too far ahead of ourselves. He is still on 17. I get your point. I'm with you. I wouldn't quite call it the config knife. Oh my. Overtime, highly likely. I take that back. He's still only a 17 and smoke's down. He has to get around them somehow. Looks toward the car and he gets it through the window. That long and in the open, Stewie. He taps on Azu's pistol as well. He uses in the open, Stewie's got another pistol. The knife does cost them and Liquid take the game in overtime. Double overtime at that.
A historic map here. That has got to be one of the craziest maps I've ever casted in my entire career. They had the game in the palm of their hand, man. They threw it in the trash. Simple in a 3-on-1, going for that knife attempt. A map point has cost them their map pick and a best of three against number one in the world.
Picks as possible. This still is a potential for this map. Still has the potential, of course, to swing in the complete opposite direction with pretty much no notice. So they want a clean round. They want a round where they can build up their monies. That's another issue that I think Rogue have been dealing with throughout not only this half but the CT side as well.
No kit. Oh, no kit. Unfortunately. Major sitting here at the back of the site. I mean, they're going to go put this bomb down.
Oh my god.
Contributing factor, they could very well turn this around now.
Oh, here we go.
I can't believe he's
pushing. No way Nico knows this.
Oh no! That's an awkward one. They'll be talking about that over the Christmas dinner table.
Mages, how he adjusts and keeps calm under pressure there is absolutely amazing. Dupree knows where Carrigan is. This could be the kill to do it. He'll be coming around the back tracks. Carrigan has no idea, but he has got vision of the bomb. Dupree needs to land two of these shots, and that's it. 16-5, an absolute battering, and he's done it, Vince. He's going to be toying with him
a little bit. This.
Not the knife! No! Dupree, what have you done that for?
If he's come back now, it's good.
At this point, I don't think so. Mertz. And Easy Attack finds the opening frag for this round. Oop. That's,
clutch it out in the 2v5. Unprecedented. And the round, the big, I bet they wish they had it many, many rounds ago, right? They were sitting on 15 for some time, and what? What? No!
The reason the bomb almost doesn't get planted in the situation after Nock makes a kill like that. Oh my god.
Okay, last time it was just thrown straight up in the sky.
W tej rundzie ze snajperką tym razem realnie, także bardzo często wymieniają się właśnie na WP-ą zawodnicy Kinguin, no ten wcelowany na bombsite zamkniętym. Jest tutaj na odnodze trzech polskich zawodników, ale tam no trzyma to wszystko jak na razie JW po flashu. Być może któryś z Polaków się wychyli. Rzucony jednak mołotow właśnie na snajpera i on będzie raczej zmuszony do wycofania, chociaż...
Przesadził JW! No chciał oczywiście zdobyć tego fraga, ale zbyt długo czekał w tym mołotowie na pan.
Breezy being one of those. Astralis have been allowed entry into the site. The bomb plant will go down as well, but it is at the cost of a player. And once again, NRG have the opportunity to go for a 5v3 retake. Magis pushing forward and taking control of some key areas of the map. Ooh. Almost kills himself with a grenade. That would have been a little
bit embarrassing. Kill from Mir's retake, and it all falls on Zen. P250, but time. Time is the biggest issue. He's inside of the smoke with eye disbalance, but he can't find the knife. The stick being stuck.
No.
Zen. Oh, he...
Wait, could they lose?
Oh!
No. Oh my god!
Stan goes upper shelf, he's dead. Stan had to go down ramp.
Oh my god!
Whoa. Oh!
What?
Oh! No!
No way!
He gets away? Fallen's gonna give chase. He's already down on the bomb site.
Stan is jumping head first for Halos. The Shazam's gonna get it done. What a round from Misfits, and what a mistake from Happy.
He can't even explain that. Hup.
Oh, he missed the ladder. No.
It's for info every time, so like they'll bait them into, you know, looking for that info. Mm.
This spot's been so strong for ColdZera, and he's got the bomb in a really nice spot position, but there are too many T's there, and that means the bomb is going to go down Street. Oh, I thought like, oh yes. My god, that's a
walk. Oh, he was going to.
No.
That through the smoke.
All angles.
Yeah, it was looking so good at that point as well. Through CT spawn, Stewie just made the call. We're going back towards A, but still managing to pick up two frags. Bolt's chiming in as well. It's up to Skadoodle now. We have mentioned him many times. He's been an absolute monster in these clutch situations. Coming up to the A bomb site, patiently looking towards library, hoping for a rotation frag here. Here's the grenade pull towards the pit, though. Might be able to pick up a frag here. Tiny gap there in the hay bales. Oh, he's gonna get knife. What are you doing, Steel? Is that worth it?
He's around the corner. Golden will smoke him off. No kit, so it's gonna be 10 seconds around here. That's surely never gonna happen. Not quite the angle. Still not either. 3 seconds left. RPK going back for it. 1 second left, and oh no! Did he come off it? He did come off, and RPK will win it. I can't believe it. He would have had it. He would have.
Yeah, they're going to get a bomb plant, and G2 has no idea. There's no one even close. They've heard the click, and they're starting to rotate now, but it might be too late.
Oh, good kill for Shox. Even better follow-up. That is such an impressive play from him. That might actually give them the round, and Dupree going to be going down. That is not how I saw that round playing out.
No, if it wasn't for that double kill from Shox, triple kill make that. Beautiful round on the defense.
Wow.
But you could see the idea behind that from Astralis. Get that plant down so quickly. You have someone lurking hut. You have device lurking.
Hello,
in ramp
Aminic.
Room. Wait.
He's the only one with the kit. What are they doing? They're not finding the bomb. No.
No one's defusing.
No.
Oh,
there
please,
could be absolutely
God.
No way.
This can't
no.
be real.
Oh. No, G2.
Holy shit.
This can't be real.
How have they done that?
No.
Well, you won't see that every
We've
day.
Seen ninja diffusers. I've never seen a ninja ball plant ever in my life before.
Oh, I can't believe they all left.
Next MB, but what can he really do with the Glock here? Maybe flank Xantares, but Jax needs to stay alive in order for that to be, you know, of any value. And right now he can't find B picks. This is so frustrating for Aminek. And he knows if he gets a one-on-one, if he gets a heads-up fight, he's going to lose it. If anyone's looking at him, he's dead. And so this kill is so important. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Xantares is split. Get the trade, but it's come at such a cost. It may come at the round's cost, as he needs to now win it.
Going for the second one, Alex. Taken down to 5 HP, 3v3, but low HP on Alex. They're not clearing heaven. Oh, fuck, we will be taken out as an effect of that. Cause and effect. Oh, no. Oh, Alex. Oh, I was kind of thinking, is he going to drop? And he did. Devil now 1v2, and that's going to be the hardest round to win. And
I what we're seeing. Okay, so we got Rops boosting on the B side. I feel like we're watching an MM game between two really sweaty teams.
Ooh.
That, ooh.
Give it another
ooh,
go.
Ooh, go again.
Time
Come
lucky.
On, Keto,
Second
right?
Time lucky.
Come on,
yeah.
man. Let's
yeah.
get it. Let's
yeah.
get it.
Oh,
oh no!
Well,
this one failed launch here. Don't worry. Back to the drawing board.
Wait. And he's going to wait for the bomb flash. W, there it is. Hopping down.
Woo! Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Yeah, this isn't what you do. But maybe it is what JW does.
He has to play Glock. If he plays AWP, his barrel sticks out. Oh, oh. No, JW. Yeah. Oh, the spam. Simon has got him.
Now down on the 1v1. Krims is going to try and pick it up. Brolin has said that he doesn't like the knifing. He doesn't love the knifing. And this.
And poor Taco just on that USP. But there's another player here. Oh, yeah. And it's KNG. Oh, no.
Getting some work done in this round, but not quite enough to really trouble G2 just yet. Though it does keep that economy a little bit lower. G2 does come away with the round fairly safely. Oh.
Oh, Apex.
Water, right? Fucking. No! Get my fucking up, man. I fell on the.
Here, take
God damn me.
Position over here towards the short side, and now Brokey, this is very hard for him. How on earth is he going to manage this? He's trying to find the engagement. Don't think he realizes he crossed over towards short side. And
oh,
no,
baby.
Not like this.
Easy does it, says Brokey.
Oh, he's still 12-0.
Yeah, he hasn't even died yet in this game.
But Brokey didn't realize when he takes that shot, when he drops out of heaven, he thinks Stiko's just staying behind the box.
But, BG Gaming. They need this few rounds here. They need the last two rounds, Tom, if they want to put up showing in the second half. I don't think five rounds is going to suffice, to be very honest.
Unless you're CIS, in which case it's more than enough. But
that is true.
But yeah, I think it's also a shame that because of the way that this match has gone, we haven't actually got to see...
No, Venkai, that's not it. You all right, Tom?
I've never seen anyone do that before.
They're doing it. They shouldn't even leave anyone towards the inner bomb site. We've seen them do it a couple of times, Simon
Gaming.
I think
Kriaz is just going to drop a smoke there, what, like 30 seconds, and hopefully you just push them in towards outside. I think, yeah, so we'll throw it like now. This would be cool, just so he can actually focus the boys outside at this point. I wouldn't even be worried about it now. Once that smoke's down, just leave it.
They can win this, though. There's 35 seconds left, and they're coming through Ivy. We've got Kios tucked on in hell. If they go sunny side, which it looks like they're going to, he gets two kills. This one's done.
Oh, my Lord. Okay. Kios, a smoke of his own as well. That's going to make them to go gray screen or wait. There's only 20 seconds they can't afford to. Na'Vi, not like this. Their worst enemy. It's the clock. And Mo, he's got another. They're running out of time. 10 seconds. They're nowhere near the bomb train. Where is the bomb? Simple's gone down. Simon Gaming with just enough time. Simple could try, but he's gone down. And Simon Gaming have done it. Over the course of three maps, they take out Na'Vi.
And he waits. Oh, he waits. Stavin waits. This is so smart. 200 IQ from him as he hopes that anyone is going to come by. And anytime soon, he's be like, they're coming. This is so smart. Stavin might have outplayed them. And he waits for more. Oh, Jesus Christ. Stavin is just so smart, but hopes that nothing is coming his back. And there he is. No! He ruins his plan. Nearly finds it, but just nearly.
Watch out for that pistol.
Oh, they go crossing into him, though, and Phase Crack finally dealt with. K Serato in with a double. That bomb, it's still to be retrieved. It's dropped into the realm of that A bomb site, and Z Power over in Maid. He's not missed the beat thus far, that's a shot miss. K Serato, this was 1v4, and now a 1v1. Almazer with this AWP, they know he plays over towards ramp so often in these rounds, and K Serato. He's waiting, patient as ever. Oh, Almaze is coming. He's running out of ammo. And now on the angle with the AWP, he's trying to bait the shot out. He's trying, and he jiggles and jiggles. But in the end, Fours are going to get it. 10 HP left on Almaze, and a fourth round locked in. They're able to...
There's also a pincer coming in towards middle as well. A battle between Nifty and Vinny, holding him back, but Ryan's still doing the work, holding down this A site. Henny should be there to execute him at least. Oh, you're not. You get what you deserve. You get what you deserve. Wanted that extra money to try and net himself something extra. Instead, there's gonna be.
This is a nightmare now. That's giving up his spot. The fact he's opened that door, Olaf knows exactly where he is. If he smokes the vent now, that would be genius play. But he knows he can come from secret as well, which he has. Oh, it's a great smoke. He's pulled himself another one as well.
More. He's got an incendiary where that came from as well.
He's heard him go towards heaven. He can even smoke that. It's an incendiary. Does it go down the ladder? Oh, no, it's beautiful.
And he's burning down to 11. One more bullet is all Olaf needs. And Amanek's so loud throughout all of this. Olaf's ears saving the day, and Amanek's had enough. Tries to deny it. Respect to Amanek as he plummets and craters for the seventh.
Insight, USP's out, but Tommy's showing up. One on one, baby.
Here we go. This is the one we've been waiting for. The clutches, the drama, the tension.
This is for
Where's
all the
that
stocks.
Bomb, though? He's got 10 seconds. Needs to get that down. Tommy will find it, though. No awkward moments here, at least.
Oh, okay. Go for the cat plant.
Yeah.
Could get flanked. Oh, my God.
No, Tommy, you've got no time.
Tommy,
you've got no time.
He's not there. You've got to put it down. You have
Tommy,
no time to do that.
That's got to be the worst moment in showmatch history.
Showmatch history.
Jason, thoughts?
I still think Bardolph isn't the spray is the worst, but that's pretty bad, isn't it?
That's embarrassing. For someone who is such a critique of all these players, doesn't
behind
even...
their success recently. Question for this semifinal becomes, Astralis is one of these teams that just doesn't seem to be making mistakes at the moment. Are we going to see a Mousesports that can challenge that? Are we going to see the one that labored through the group stage? Are we going to see the one that rose through the ranks of the professional scene for the past 6 months?
Question to be answered. The Mowdown comes in. It's a bloodbath in middle. Dupree
3.
Oh, no.
You hate to see it. You hate to see it. Sunny with the